The Wendigo is part of the folklore and beliefs of some of the native populations, Algonquin-speaking peoples, which describe the Wendigo as a malevolent supernatural being associated with winter, starvation, and cannibalism. When you examine the beliefs of the native cultures, briefly, what originated the legend of the Wendigo?
And then you would go back to that of the spirits of the seasons themselves, and that of a time of great despair, famine, and the experiences that caused the peoples to survive. This would be in the folklore that of the will of the people to overcome any and all depravity or here lack, referring to that of times of great famine or starvation, and the will of the people to survive or overcome these devastations. They would be during the time of night, or that of the long winters. That of the spirit of winter would be seen as a revengeful one, to be seen something like the Grim Reaper, as would be seen in other remnants or thoughts. That there was this time in which there would be darkness and death, starvation. But again, to endure these times, the spirit would overcome any and all of these difficulties, these that were associated with what would be the dark spirits, or those dimensions or worlds that would be of the mischievous minds or discarnate beings. Hence that of the use of death, and that of the will of people that would be so hungry they would do anything, including that of cannibalism, to survive. Not that it was a teaching, but that it was the will of people to survive. Taking strength, doing whatever was necessary to overcome these extremely cold and devastating times. Of course, the myth and legend had been embellished. It would start off as a story of how people had to do what they did to survive, and that it took great courage and tenacity and will, and then it was embellished into more and more of a superhuman great spirit of this season or this episode in human behavior. People will do so much to survive, and that hunger can drive them to do whatever it takes to survive. And here the intention is to show one side of the seasonal activities, but that of the dread of freezing cold, starving, and desperate people, and how they overcame this, albeit likewise meeting horrific and tragic circumstances to do so, was the will of the people, not all, what the intention was to show this part of human nature, not to be ashamed but to be aware of this direction.